This conference will now be recorded.
Hello, good morning everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Okay, today we are going to learn new software name called CorelDRAW. I think already you are heard about this CorelDRAW. In Photoshop only I explained about this CorelDRAW. Yes,
completed with Photoshop, ma'am.
Yeah, Photoshop is over. Last class I told, no, Photoshop is over.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
So we are going to learn CorelDRAW 2017. So it has been introduced from 1989. So from that day we are using, like, almost a Photoshop, when they introduced Photoshop, almost the same duration. Okay, and already I have told about this thing, what is vector and raster. So this is fully based on vector based editing software. So CorelDRAW 2017 you're going to learn, and vector, this is vector editing software. That means in this whatever you do, it won't work as pixels. Like Photoshop, it won't work. Photoshop is totally different from CorelDRAW. And CorelDRAW is Corel Corporation. So from the word, there only it is there, like Adobe Photoshop is there, no, like that, it is CorelDRAW. Actually, DRAW is the original name. Corel is company. And under Corel, we have other softwares also, like Corel Paint, Corel Photos, like that, we have other softwares also. But the famous one is CorelDRAW. And this is not free. This one also, you have to pay for it. Or else you can use trial version. Okay, now we'll see how to open CorelDRAW. So if the software is installed, the icon will be there in the desktop, or else you can go to start menu, you can search for CorelDRAW, then you can open that, or else just a double click on the icon which is there in the desktop.
I'll be recording.
When you're opening the software, you have to give skip, do not give continue. Okay. Once you open CorelDRAW software, this is your workspace. Okay. So first only we'll create one new document. I'll tell you afterwards, I'll explain about this. Okay. So this is your workspace, and same like Photoshop, we have title bar. So Coral Draw 2017 64-bit, and this is untitled. That means the document name has been by default it has given untitled one, and this one is menu bar. We have file menu, edit menu, view menu, so lots of menus we have, and this thing is called a standard bar. Okay, this is standard, and you can do right click. You can on the standard bar, you can right click. If you want, you can enable or disable. You can do standard bar, and this thing is called a property bar. And this is like same like Photoshop. If you select the tool, this is toolbox. In the toolbox, if you select any tools, just select any tools, automatically property bar will get enabled. Okay, so for each tool we have different types of properties. So example, pick tool, the first tool is called pick tool. There will in Photoshop we'll call this as move tool. Here we will call this as pick tool, and each time it will get changed. The property will get changed based on the tools. And right side will be seeing color palette, and the bottom will be seeing recently used color palettes. And here everything is called pages, not artboard or canvas, it is pages. So you can create n number of pages. Now right now we are in page one. Like in Excel you are creating pages, no? Like that here also you can create number of pages. So example, if you click on this icon, it will create one more page. If you don't want, right click and delete. So that and all we'll see in upcoming class. So by default one page will be created, and this is your work area. Here only you have to work. So we have, it doesn't mean that you have to work on only inside the page. You can work outside also, but the problem is whatever is there in the inside page, only that will be printed. So that will be only that will be your output. Suppose if you create anything outside, it won't come in as a output. And this color palette, wherever you want, you can move it. Just click and drag. You can move it wherever you want. Suppose if you want in the top, you can keep it in the top, or in the sides or bottom, wherever you want to, just drag and keep it. So from here you can drag and move it wherever you like. So this is called color palette. So this is our workspace of CorelDRAW. Okay, now we'll see how to take new document. We can press Ctrl N, or else go to File menu, click on New option, and we'll get this window, small dialog box, like in Photoshop, how you got. After this, first thing is name. Name if you can give now itself, or else you can give afterwards also, no problem. And preset destination. So always taking new document is the first thing. And a preset destination, that one you can choose anything in this. Example, custom is there. Custom means you can choose your own size, or else you can choose CorelDRAW default. Coral default means it will choose as letter as the default page. So like that, website means in pixel it will come. So like that, different types of things will be there, but I'm going to choose as custom. In the custom, I'm going to choose the size. You can see after preset destination the size you see. Okay, size you take as A4 right now, because in India mostly we will use A4 only. So choose as A4, but you have other sizes also, A3, A6, A5, but right now A4 is best. And after that, Suppose if you want to give manual size also directly you can type here, and you can always change the units: inches, millimeter, picas, point, again pixels. So anything you can choose here. It can support feet, kilometer, miles, everything, but maximum will take as feet. And number of pages, directly you can give number of pages now itself, or else afterward, after creating a document also you can create number of pages. And another thing is color mode. Color mode is more important. In CorelDRAW by default CMYK color will be there. Example, if you choose CorelDRAW default, by default it will take as CMYK, because in CorelDRAW everything almost will work for printing media only, and Photoshop will work mostly for digital media. So that's why there it will take as RGB, here it will take as CMYK. But here also you can choose RGB if you want, but CMYK only it is recommended when you are working in CorelDRAW. So you know already what is CMYK and RGB, as I explained in the Photoshop itself. So CMYK means cyan, magenta, yellow and black. RGB means red, green, blue. And rendering resolution. When it comes to rendering resolution, we can see DPI, same like in Photoshop. In Photoshop, we'll call as pixels per inch. There we'll call as PPI. Here we'll call as DPI. So because CorelDRAW is mostly will work for printing media, no? So that's why we'll call as in printing media, we'll call as DPI. PPI means pixel per inch, and DPI means dots per inch. Actually both are same only, but in printing media will call as dots, in digital media will call as pixel. So but both are same only. So by default it will only take as 300. But you can make it, actually it won't go more than 300, but you can reduce to 72. And you can choose preview mode as enhanced. This one will say afterwards when you are learning layout menu. There also I'll explain about this. But as a beginner, you have to use enhanced. And that's it. And you can choose as landscape mode or portrait mode. Landscape means vertical, sorry, portrait means vertical, and landscape means portrait, sorry, horizontal. This one is there in Word also, so I'll choose as landscape and give OK. So this document has taken in landscape mode, and if you see, this one is in portrait mode. So always you can see the documents, the number of documents you have created. Untitled one, untitled two, and the welcome screen. So like Google tabs, it will work. So you can create n number of documents by here also in the file menu, or else you can press Control N. So however you want. And if you don't want any document, just move to the tab, just click on this int mark, automatically the document will get closed. Okay. Here everything is not layer based, so we want to use layers here. Instead of that, we will use objects. Everything is object we have. For example, in the toolbox, if you see, we have rectangle, ellipse, and polygon. First, we'll take rectangular shape. We'll draw a rectangular box. See, click on the tool, rectangular tool, and just if you mouse left click and drag, if you do, it will make rectangular shape. And by taking pick tool, you can select any objects. And you can select multiple objects also. And you can do delete. Just press delete key. If you want a perfect square or circle, means you have to hold control key, then mouse left click and drag. By holding control key, we can make perfect square. Hold control key and press mouse left click and drag. For square or for mostly perfect shapes. Suppose if you're taking ellipse tool, why it is called ellipse means because by default you can't make any that means the proper circle you can't make without holding control key. That's why it is called ellipse shape, and this is called rectangular shape. Okay, suppose if you want perfect circle, hold control key, then mouse left click and drag. So we'll make perfect circle. So you can make ellipse shapes or oval shape without holding control key. Like that for rectangular shape. So however you want, you can make it. Just mouse left click and drag for rectangular shapes. Okay. After making any shapes, if you want to fill color inside, you have to first make the shape and then take pick tool, select the object. So how to identify whether the object is selected or not? Always you can see 1, 2, 3, around 8 dots around the shape. So that means that object got selected. Only this object is selected, this object is not selected now. So now this object is selected, this is not selected. So the transform control will be there. So what is transform control? Which is position, scaling, and rotation. Already I told in Photoshop, position and scaling and rotation. These three things is called transform controls. Transforming one place to another place, or rotation, changing the position, and making it bigger or smaller. So that is transform control. After selecting the object, this 8 dots will be the square dots. After that, you go to the color palette, mouse left click, you do which color you want, just mouse left click. After selecting the object, mouse left click. Mouse left click is for fill color. Filling the color inside the object. And mouse right click for outline color or stroke color, you can call. Outline or stroke color, mouse right click. See, after selecting the object, you can increase the stroke size by going to the property bar. Just select the object by using pick tool. So this is called pick tool. And go to this, and the property bar, you'll be seeing one pen tool symbol. And in that, you click on the colors. So increase the values after stroke. And you can zoom in, zoom out by scroll button. Now mouse right click, if you do, the outline color will get changed. Which color you want, just mouse left click on the color palette. And mouse left click is for fill color, mouse right click is for outline color. Mouse right click and mouse left click for fill color. So always you have to select the object, then you have to give the colors. So now I have not selected any object. And if you fill the color, it won't give. And here you can see the recent colors you are used in the color palette, because in color palette we have lots of colors. So you can see in the bottom, you can see the colors which are used recently. So always you can use that repeatedly. Okay. For zoom in, control plus equals equal is for zoom in. And control plus minus for zoom out. Or else you can use for scroll in, scroll up also. Scroll button up and down if you use. For zoom in, zoom out. And scroll button you can, if you press. Hand tool example, if you go to CorelDRAW, to move the work area, if you press click and hold the scroll button, you can get a hand symbol, hand tool, and you can move the workspace. Click and hold, you can move the workspace scroll button you have to click and hold and scroll up for zoom in zoom out, or you can use Control plus and minus for zoom in zoom out. Wherever you keep the cursor, from there you can zoom in. Only that part. If you want to zoom in the center, we keep the cursor over there, then you can zoom in zoom out. You can do, there is no need of holding any Control or Shift key for zoom in zoom out. And if you want to do undo and redo, just Control plus Z is equals to undo. And Control plus Shift. Plus Z is equals to redo. So Control Z, undo whatever you done. You can go backward. And Control Shift Z is to redo. So you can come forward, backward, and forward. Okay. Suppose if you don't want the outline of the object, if you don't want the outline, if you don't want the color palette, we have different types of colors like that. And the before black color, so this is black. On top of the black, if you see, one empty color box will be there. That one int symbol will be there. That means no colors. And in the recent color also, you can see that. So this means no color. And go to that color option. Left click if you do, outline will be removed. Sorry, right click if you do, outline will get removed. And if you do left click, inside color also will get removed. Actually, the object is there, but no colors, no outline also, no fill color also. So again, if you want, again same mouse left click and right click if you do, again the color will come back. If you want to increase the outline size, after selecting the object, go to the property bar. There you'll be having outline options. You can increase the outline size. So always you can give any color you like. If you don't want, you can click on this. Right click for outline. And left click for fill color. So same concept for circle also. Just draw the circle or ellipse. So same thing, you can give fill color, outline color, and you can increase the outline size. And for polygon also same thing. So fill the color and increase the outline size. Okay, so this is called polygon. Actually, not only this, even rectangle results, rectangle tool also, it is polygon. And these are called polygon shapes. We should not call this as polygon. Polygon shapes. What is mean by polygon shapes means, if you are able to fill color inside, those things are called polygon shapes. Okay, so if I'm able to fill color inside any shapes, that is called polygons. Okay, so now you tell me, what is the minimum side of a polygon? Anyone, those who knows, you can answer. You can answer in the chat menu also. What will be the minimum side? Example, this is also polygon, this also it is polygon. That means I should be able to fill color inside. You can type. What is the minimum side? So I should give color inside like this. I want to give color inside. Okay, 4. What about others?
Ma'am, three
Everyone
or
clear?
more sides, ma'am.
Okay. So minimum three we required, correct? Yeah. So
yes, ma'am.
Just to select the polygon, just to select the polygon, and if you see in the property bar, you can increase the sides. So decrease the side by this option. So less than three, it won't go. So I'm keep on clicking, but it is not going less than three. If I try to type two also, it won't go. Okay. So minimum side is three. If less than three means it is called lines. So you can't give any fill color if it is less than three. So minimum side is three. Okay. Now you tell me what is the maximum side we need. Or what is the maximum side I can give fill color? Anyone? Okay, nine. What about others? Eight. Okay, so after the selecting this polygon shape, I'll increase the sides. So three is there, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 17, 18. So I can zoom in and check. So I'll give around 50. Can zoom in and check.
Ma'am, it's n number, ma'am.
Yes, it is infinity. So the maximum side is infinity for a polygon. So that means if I, so from here to here, it is one line. Suppose if I want, I can make one more line here, one more point here. I can make one more point here. So it is infinity, but CorelDRAW can support only maximum 500. So I'll give 1000. But it will take only 500 maximum, because almost it will look like circle. So that's why they given only 500. So maximum CorelDRAW can support 500, but actually it is infinity. And you can check, if we zoom into that, you can check the distance. See, so actually this is one line. So okay, that one we'll see later how to adjust the points and all. So minimum side is three, maximum side is infinity of the polygon. Okay. But so for polygon we have this kind of options, but if you take rectangle we have other options. Example, I'll make a perfect square, or rectangle also if you want you can make. So perfect square, so after making perfect square, take pick tool. Okay, once the shape shape, this is called object, actually object or shape you can call, rectangular shape or a square shape, and we can move this anywhere by taking pick tool. And I'll give fill color by mouse left click, and if you want you can give outline also. After that, you see the property bar, what under option is that? This is XY axis position. Okay, so always remember that this is position, object position, and this is width and height of the object. So I can make sure that this is whether perfect square or not by seeing this values. So width is 4.604 and height is also 4.604. So that means this is perfect square, because sometime you'll feel like this is perfect square. So this is looks like perfect square, but if you see the measurement, it is not perfect because width is more, height is less. Okay, so what you can give directly, you can type the values 5 into 5 inches and give enter. So we can make perfect square. Suppose if you want to make rectangle also, can make example, I want to make rectangle around 10 into, so width as 10, height as 5, and give enter. So automatically it will make 10 into 5 inch of rectangular size, and give fill color to that. So after this, you can see a lock symbol over here. So what is the lock? What is the use of lock symbol means? See, now if you adjust the value here, only width will get adjust, but height it won't get adjust. So if you want to maintain the ratio of the rectangular shape, just to lock it, then if you give 14. So width also will get automatically adjust. So 14 into 10. So before it was 5 into 10. Sorry, 7 into 5. And once you increase after locking, so both the width and height will get increased. Okay, and after that you can see rotation angle value. So if I rotate this object, how much, example, I rotate around 25 degree, so around 360 degree only you can rotate. Okay, so I given rotation around 25. If you want, you can make it 360, but 360 is useless. Even 90 degree also is useless for a square shape. But if it is a rectangular shape, then you can see the difference. I'll make it 0. So this is 0. Now if I give 90 degree, so it will be vertical. Okay. Suppose if you're giving 45 degree, it will be a little bit crass. For square shape, I'll give around 45 degree. So like this kind of diamond shape you can get. So this also you can play with it. So width and height and rotation. So first is, this three thing is called transform controls. So position, scaling, and rotation. And next thing is mirroring. So if I do mirror of this object, no changes will happen. So mirror will come back. See, after this, if you will be seeing round corner and sculpt corner and diamond corner or chamfered. Okay. So what is the use of this? If you click on this also, no changes will happen. So then what we have to do? So before seeing this, we'll create a logo which is called SBI logo. Have you seen SBI logo? SBI.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is SBI logo, no? So you tell me the procedure to do this, so I'll follow the step. So whatever tool I taught today, by only using that, I have to do that. So tell me the procedure, I'll create SBI logo. Anyone? Any volunteers?
Ma'am, first we have to do with circle shape, ma'am.
Okay. For making perfect circle, I have to hold Control key, then drag it. Next. So circle shape is done. Next. Next, what to do? Okay, I'll fill color in this. Next.
One more circle inside that circle.
Okay, one more perfect circle inside that. So I have to arrange this properly, correct? So always remember that if you move the mouse to the center point, it will show as center. Okay, you can see the text over there. So it shows as center, and if you move to the edge, that means midpoint, it will show as quadrant, and edge means edge. Okay, so everything it will show. Suppose if it is not showing, means you can go to edit menu, sorry, view menu. In that you can enable alignment guide and dynamic guides. Suppose if it is not showing center and quadrant. So I'll click and hold on the center, and I'll move it to that. One more circle is there, no? For the center, I'll place it. So now it is placed exactly to the center. So I'll reduce the size of this. Okay, next, what to do?
Rectangle from inner circle to outer.
Okay, I'll take one rectangular shape. So I'll draw one rectangular shape in vertical mode. I'll take pick tool. Okay, so if you move to the rectangular, it will show as node point. Instead of quadrant, it will show as node point, and midpoint it will show. Okay, you can see that midpoint and node point and the edges, and if you move to the center, it will show as center. So I'll move it to the midpoint, click and hold on that, and move it to the center. So you can zoom in by scroll button. So till you get the center point, you place it. So this midpoint and the center point is exactly placed, and you can adjust the width according to that. Again, you can click on this midpoint and place it in the center. Okay, next, what to do? Still it is not looking like SBI logo. Okay, I have to fill with white color. Okay, next, what to do? But it's not looking like SPI logo, no? See this outline and all, it is visible. Anyone? So nothing, you have to select the object. See, when you want to select object, you can hold shift key. For selecting multiple object, you can hold shift key, or else you can click and drag, which is there in the dotted box. Only that object will get select. So only these two objects is got selected. When you are clicking and dragging, you will get one dotted box over there, and which is inside that dotted box, only that object will get select. So now only these two object will get select. Suppose if you want to select this entire object, you can select like this, or else you can hold shift key, then one by one you can click and select. Then go to this empty box, the color palette, right click you do, so the outline will get removed. Then it look like SBI logo. So anyone has doubt in this? So by using only these two shapes, we created this. Okay. So we'll group this. Control G for group. After selecting multiple objects, you can group by Control G, or else you can do right click and group it. And that alignment option is not enabled, means go to view menu. in the view menu, enable alignment guide. And dynamic guide. So I group this object, I'll keep it aside. Okay. Now I'll make perfect square. So in the property bar, if you see sculpt corner, and after selecting this square shape or rectangular shape also, this will get enabled. Round corner, sculpt corner, and chamfered. But if you click on this, nothing will happen. So what we have to do is, after clicking on this, if you see four values will be here, 1, 2, 3, 4. This four values for these four corners. This corner value is the top one, and this corner value is this one. This one is for bottom, this bottom two is for bottom two. Okay. Now you unlock this symbol and give some value this. So I have this, this square shape is around 3.4 inch. I'll give around 1. See, only this corner got around, no? That means round corner. And this is sculpt and diamond. So I'll make it to 0. Now I'll lock this. Now you make it 1. So the four corner will get adjust once you lock. So this also become 1. This also became 1. This also became 1. So the four corner values became 1. And sculpt and a diamond. That means chamfered. So if you reduce more, I'll give around 4, means it look like circle. So only one side if you want, you have to unlock and 0. Got it? Only one side you can make it. Now what I'm going to do, this one I'll make it to perfect 4 into 4. Now everything I'll make it 0, and I'll do lock and unlock only two. Like I won't make like leaf safe. So this one I'll make it to 4 inches, which is the side of this, and so we'll get like a half circle. And this, opposite to this angle, I'll make it 4. Suppose if you're working on millimeter, means you have to give more in values. I'm working in inches, so I given less. Suppose the unit is in millimeter. If we click outside, we can change always the units. Now it will be in millimeter. You have to give in hundreds or 50 like that. And you can see here, it is 101 millimeter, the width and height. So which one you are comfortable, just click outside of the paper. And always you can change the units. Right? So now the leaf is done. Now this one, if you do mirror, you can see the difference. So mirror horizontally and vertically. Got it? And we can do rotation also by entering the rotation value here. Okay. So this property is first square shape. But if you take circle or ellipse, for this it will come different. So these three same, but here full ellipse safe and pie chart. In Excel, is there no pie chart like that? Will come. You can give the values after clicking on pie chart or pie. Sorry, you should not call it chart, pie, and give the values around 90 degree. I'll make it around 180. So half the circle will come. I'll make it 45, half of the 90 degree. And this is only arc, so only line will be there, no fill color you can give. So only arc shape. So you can't give fill color inside. But if you click on pie, it'll give fill. You can give fill color inside. Arc means no fill color. Pie means you can fill color, and you can again convert to normal circle. Okay. So now you got the properties of rectangle, circle, and a polygon. Polygon means only you can increase the sides. So now you tell me, everyone knows Instagram logo? Have you seen Instagram logo?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now you have to tell me how to create this Instagram logo. So whatever option I thought. No need of gradient color, just plain color is enough. So example, let us think this logo you have to create, this black logo. And you can tell the procedure, I'll follow that. Any volunteers?
First, we should take square shape, ma'am.
Okay, hold control key, make it perfect square. Then?
And ma'am, and edges, we have to make curve, all the four edges.
How to make?
Ma'am, by this option, above option, we have okay. to give the value, ma'am.
So if I give value, so it is around 5 inches. So I'll give around 1 inch. Only one side it is adjusting, you know what to do. I won't adjust four corners.
Ma'am, all the four values we have to give, ma'am.
No, we have to lock it. Then if you adjust one value, it'll get adjust automatically. So I'll give around 1.5. Got it? So once you lock, so all the four corners value will get adjust evenly. Okay. So I'll fill with black color. Next, what to do?
Circle inside that square, ma'am.
Okay, I'll make one perfect circle. So that one I'll give with white color. Next, and we can see the logo. So inside two circles, one white ring and one black circle. Next, what to do?
One more small circle above this big circle.
Okay. This one I'll do Control C, Control V, copy paste. I'll reduce the size of this from the corner and fill with white color. Sorry, black color. Okay, black color. Arrange it exactly to the center. Okay, next. But if you see one more white ring, square outer ring is there, no? That one.
Insert one more square inside that square.
Okay. So this one, what I'll do? So this one is black. Already black is there. This one I'll do copy paste. Control C, Control V, and make it bigger. Okay. And arrange it exactly to the center. But if you see, I'm not able to see the background objects. So that's why first only you should think which one have to create first. Okay. Otherwise, like this will happen. If you create any object, so this object is bigger than that objects. So this one has to be created first itself. So now it is not visible. So what to do? Nothing. You have to select this object. Do Control X and Control V. Cut paste. Now this will become in front. And this one I'll give white color. And if you want, you can reduce the size a little bit. And one more black ring is there. This one I'll move it here. So this only I'll do copy paste. I'll make it bigger. I'll fill with black color. More side. Control X. Control V. Again, place exactly to this center. And remove the outlines if it is required. And group it. Control G. And one more thing is there, no? Here we have to make one small hole, no? And fill with white color in that. So anyone has doubt in this? So make sure that which one you want behind, that one you have to create first. Otherwise, you have to do Control X, Control V like that you have to do. So this also reduce and keep it aside. So Instagram logo, anyone has doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. See, if you practice some logos only, you can create your own logo. Now we'll create. Anyone seen Adidas logo? Almost everyone seen Adidas. So now you have to tell me how to create this leaf logo. No, text don't bother, only this leaf I want to create. So 1, 2, 3 and some 3 lines is there. Anyone? First, what I have to take? Any volunteers? Okay, so first I have to create perfect square, then unlock this symbol in the property bar.
I am a boy, but in the middle.
And this also give around 4. So based on your side value, more than this side value, you have to give and give enter. So the leaf has been created. So next step, at least you can tell. So I created one leaf. Next, what to do? So I'll fill with black color. This only I'll do Control C, Control V. So don't think that it is not copied. When you do Control C and Control V, that means copy paste on the same location, it will do copy paste. Then you move this, and once again you do Control C, Control V. So three leaves came, and this one you do mirror. Okay, and this one you rotate around 45 degree, then it will become straight. Got it? So now the bottom you have to arrange properly. That's it. So for that you make one rectangular shape. Okay, so it will be easy to arrange. Then click and hold on this node point and move it to this edge, and here also click and hold on this, move it to this edge, click and hold on this, move it to this edge. Suppose if you want to make it perfectly, so the adjust these values. So according to the size. And distance between this and this is same means okay. So anyone can tell me how to make these lines over here? My voice is audible to you, no?
Yeah, ma'am, we have to take rectangle shape, ma'am.
Okay. Then make a small strip over here and fill with white color. So you can zoom in for adjust the side, and this only you can do copy paste, correct? Then arrange it. Control C, Control V, and arrange it. So next, select this only this strip, and go to this removing color. Right click on that. So this Adidas logo has been created. So this everything you can select and make it group, Control G. And this is also keep it aside. Okay, this logo from your side only, I want the answer. One more logo will create. So this BMW logo I want to create. So everyone know what is BMW?
Yes, ma'am.
What is BMW?
It's car, ma'am.
Okay. So now you tell me how to create this logo. Anyone?
First, we have to take circle, ma'am.
Okay. So perfect circle. Next. So if you want
to
see
inside that, we have to take another circle.
So one more. Which is smaller circle? This bigger circle.
And we have bigger to take smaller circle.
Small.
Okay. So I'll do Control C, Control V. I'll reduce the size of that. Okay, that one I'll fill with black color, and this one I'll increase the stroke size. I give around 8. Next thing.
Again, insert one more circle inside this circle.
So this one I'll do copy, paste. I'll reduce the size. Little bit of increase. I'll give with white colors. So make see how I created first this one, I created then this one and then this one. Don't create first this one, then this one, because this won't be visible because this is smaller object. Okay. Now you tell me what to do. I want that piece, no?
And we have to take square shape, ma'am.
Square. Okay, square. Hold control key. Then what to do? If I adjust this corner, it won't look good, no? Then if I place, it is not perfect. Correct, huh?
Yes, sir.
Then fill the color. Suppose if you're finding difficulty in this, so this circle only you select, press Ctrl C and Ctrl V and fill color in that. See, pi and make it 90 degree. So that's it. And this only you duplicate, that means Ctrl C, Ctrl V and place it over here. Flip horizontally and vertically. And node to node. These two you can select. Reduce little bit. And remove the outlines. The text part we'll see in the next class. So in this anything I have doubt, is there anything remaining? Yeah, almost done.
Ma'am, only the thing how is, to remove the lines.
On the color palette, after selecting the object, right click on this empty box. You can see one empty box here, the color palette.
Yes, ma'am.
So there, mouse left click, if you do, automatically the outline will get removed. Mouse right click, if you do, outline will remove. Mouse left click, if you do, fill color will remove. So Control Z and do. So that one I have written in this. See, mouse left click for fill color, mouse right click for outline color. That is for removing also. But only the thing is, you have to click on this box. So this also you select and group it. Control G. And keep aside. So next thing is this MasterCard logo, and with this we'll finish up the class. Anyone tell me how to create this MasterCard logo?
So first we have to take circle mark.
Okay, two circles we'll create, and which is orange or red color, and this one I'll do copy paste. Then move it. So click and hold on the center point, you'll get exactly quadrant. Then change it to orange color. Now you tell me how to make that inside color, this one. So now I want to create that one. Anyone? So this much you can create it easily. main thing is I want this one. Okay, so nothing, take one square shape, so according to this, then make like leaf. Rotate around 45 degree, so it will become vertical, and reduce the height of this and place it over here and zoom in, adjust the height according to this. And in that you give with the dark orange. But if we have other method, easy method, but that one we'll do it later. And to get a dark orange, long press on the color palette, mouse left click, long press. If you do similar to that color, you'll get lot of colors. Suppose if you press on yellow color, similar to yellow color, we'll get lot of colors, and red also same thing. Mouse left click, and that's it, and remove the outline of this. So finally, how to save this? Just go to file menu, or you can press Ctrl S, click on save option, and CorelDRAW will save in .cdr. .cdr format, it will get safe. Like Photoshop, how it saves .psd, no? Like that, you can save in .cdr. So whenever you want, you can edit this back. And you can choose the version when you want to, when you're saving. Suppose if you want to save in previous version, also you can save and save it. I'll go to desktop, and that document, yeah, it is saved here, logos one. So in that all the logos will be there. And in some system we may don't have CorelDRAW software. For them, you can save it in PDF format. Go to File menu, Export. Instead of Save as or Save, you have to give us Export. In that export, you go for PDF, Adobe Portable Document Format. And you can give some name for that and give choose desktop or wherever you want and save it. And after that, it will ask number of pages. Right now, I created only one page. If you create multiple pages, you can choose and just give OK. Don't change anything, just give OK. More about that, we'll see later. And you can open this document. Okay, and if you see this BMW logo is not visible off of the thing because this is our paper size. Whatever is inside the paper, only that will be visible. But you can work while working in CorelDRAW, you can work on this full area here, wherever you want, you can create any objects. But when you want to save as image, PDF document, you have to be careful. So the objects has to be inside the page. So then only it will come inside. So saving the document, any doubts? And exporting? Okay then, so that's it for today, and if you have any doubt you can ask now. Always save as PDF plus CorelDRAW document, so then it will be good because you can view this in phone also, PDF document, but this one you can't view in phone or some other device. So for CorelDRAW document we need always CorelDRAW software. And this document will be saved in .cdr. Okay then. So this is enough for today. Anyone has questions? Any doubts? Okay, then thank you everyone. Then I'll end the class.